The first question is, choose the correct statements from the following. Force is a product of mass into velocity. That is, F is equal to mv. Now, it's wrong because we already know that F is equal to mass into acceleration. So this is not the correct option. Moment is a product of mass and acceleration. No, it is force, it is mass into acceleration. So this is wrong. This is also wrong. Torque is a product of mass and gravitational acceleration. That means we are telling that T is equal to mg. No, torque is not equal to mg. It is weight which is equal to mg. So this is also not the correct option. Now let us analyze this. Moment is a product of force and perpendicular distance. Yes, this is the correct option. We have moment is equal to force into perpendicular. This is the correct option, option number A. Option B. Next question. The process of finding out the resultant force is called dash of force. So if you find out resultant of force, that is known as composition of forces. We have seen this in LMR. When we combine all the forces, that is known as composition. And when we resolve the forces into X and Y components, it is known as resolution. So this option will be option A. Next question. The process of splitting, the process of splitting out the forces into components is called dash of forces. So it will be resolution of forces. Again, we have seen the LMR part. So option will be B. Next. A system of two forces which are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, and have line of action parallel but at a non-zero distance is called. So basically, this is a definition of a couple. When there are two equal and opposite forces in opposite direction but separated by a non-zero distance. The distance is not there, non-zero, hence it will be forming a couple. So answer will be option number B. Force can be resolved into dash components. So we have seen here that if it is a xy plane, then the force will be resolved in two components, that is fx and fy. And if it is a 3D plane, then force are divided or force are resolved into three parts, that is fx, fy, and z. So if there are more number of axes considered, the forces resolved can be n number of axes. It can be infinite number of resolution possible about a force. The answer will be D. Next question. State in which of the following actions the applied force does not produce movement. So pedaling a bicycle, if you pedal a bicycle, there is a rotary motion, so movement is there. Stretching a spring. Imagine you have a spring in your hand and you are stretching it. So there is no movement, there is just a linear translation or linear movement. So this is the correct option in which does not produce movement. Option B. Next. If two forces of 5 kg and 7 kg act at right angles to each other, please note down. Two forces of 5 kg is given. Then the resultant force will be. First of all, as there are two forces, I will make it like this. Let us say 5 kg and this is 7 kg. As it is 80, we have to first convert it into Newton. So it will be 5 into 9.81 and this will be 7 into 9.81 with angle 90 degrees with each other. So now what will be the answer? It's very simple. You can apply polygon, you can apply parallelogram law of force, or you can also apply. We have summation of fx is equal to. So fx will be 5 into 9.81. Then we have summation of fy is equal to 7 into 9.81. And finally, I can write R is equal to square root of summation fx square plus summation of f1. So it will be square root of 5 into 9.81 square plus 7 into 9.81 square. If I solve this, I should get the answer as 84.34 Newton. Option number 3. This is option B, not C. Next question. Force P equal to 390 Newton acting at an angle of 30 degrees with respect to positive x axis. Okay. This is positive x axis. And there is a force P of 390 Newton acting at an angle of 30 degrees determines x and y components of it. That means we need to resolve this into two components, one in x and one in y. Let us resolve it. So this component will be 390 cos of 30, and this will be 390 sine of 30. So this will come out to be as 337.9, and this will come out to be as 195 meters. So the correct option is option number B. Next question. If the force is 1 Newton, 2 Newton, 3 Newton, 4 Newton and 5 Newton acting in the order of a sides of a rectangular regular pentagon, 1 Newton force is acting horizontally towards left, then the resultant is. In the question it is given that there is a regular pentagon, so it will be like this. There is a regular pentagon and we are given that the first force of 1 Newton is acting horizontally towards left. So this is the 1 Newton force. And then we have to go line by line along the sides. In, because it is given here, it is acting in order. So after 1, there will be 2 Newton force. Then there will be 3 Newton force. Then there will be 4 Newton force. And finally, there will be a 5 Newton force. Now you can see that all the forces are inclined except this one. We need to resolve all these forces. So first resolution will be done here. Then here it will be one resolution. Then this force will be resolved somewhere here. Then this force will be resolved. Now after resolution, we need the angles. So for angle, we know that this angle of a pentagon is nothing but 72 degrees. Because the inside angle is 102. Degrees. If this is 32, this will be, if this is 72, this will be 36 degrees because the total should be 108, this angle. Out of it, if this is 72, this will be 36. If this is 36, this angle is also 36, and this angle we all know it is. If this is 72, this angle will be 72. So now all the resolution has been done, so we can now write. Okay, let me write the resolution forces first. So this will be 2 cos 72. This will be 2 sine 72. Similarly, this will be 3 sine 36. And this will be 3 cos 36. This component will be 5 sine 72. And this will be 5 cos 72. Here, this component will be 4 cos 36, and this will be 4 sine 36. So, the important thing in this was the angles and the resolution. Just is simple. First, I will write summation of fx. So, for fx, it will be minus 1, this force, then minus 2 cos 72, then third force will be plus 3 cos 36, then plus 4 cos 36. Minus 5 cos 72. So if we solve this expression, we will get answer for fx is equal to 2.5 Newton. This is fx. Then summation of fy. Add all the forces in y direction. So we have 2 sine 72, then plus 3 sine 36, minus 4 sine 36, minus 5 sine 72. So if I solve this, I will get answer as summation of fy is minus 3.440. So finally, I will write therefore r is equal to square root of 2.5 square plus 3.44 square. So the answer I will get is 4.25 newtons, which is option number A. Next question. Two unlike parallel forces of 20 newtons act at an angle of 35 degrees with horizontal. The horizontal distance between them is 2 meters. The couple formed by them is. The question given is like this. There is a force of 20 Newton acting at an angle of 35 degrees. It is 35 degrees. And it is forming a couple. So it will be equal and opposite force here. So it is also a 20 Newton force acting at an angle of 35 degrees. we need to find, and the distance between them is 2 meters, and we need to find out the couple formed by them. So couple basically is the force or the vertical forces, the forces which make a couple multiplied by the distance. So if I resolve this component, it will be, now if you observe that the couple is made only by the vertical component, this 20 cos 35 and 20 cos 35 are not parallel to each other, they are in line. So the only parallel forces are this and this. So the answer will be couple is equal to, it is making a clockwise couple, so it will be minus 20 sine 35 multiplied by distance is 2. So when you solve it, the answer you will get is 22.95 newton-meter. So unlike parallel forces of 15 newton and 20 newton are acting 2 meter apart on a member, then their resultant will be. Okay. So there are two forces, two unlike parallel forces. So if I make here as 15 newton, this will be downward force of 20 newton, and they are acting 2 meters apart. So we need to find out where the resultant forces will act. So first of all, I need to find the resultant. So resultant of this force will be 15 minus 20, which is equal to minus 5 newton. Now, to locate the position of resultant, we use Verignon's theorem, which states that the summation of moment of a force about a point, so let us take this point as A, is equal to moment of resultant about the same point, that is A. Summation of moment of all forces. So if I take moment of forces from here, there is only one force which is picking up clockwise moment, so it will be minus of 20 into 2. And this should be equal to moment caused by the resultant. So if resultant is minus 5, it is somewhere here. R is equal to 5 newton going downward, and let this distance be x. So I will get it as minus 5 into x. So if I solve this, I will get x is equal to 20 into 2 by 5, which will be equal to x is equal to 8 meters. The total length is 2 meters, and we are getting the answer that resultant will be acting somewhere around here, which is 8 meters from here. So we can tell that it is outside the two forces. Option number 4 forces, 25 newton, 25 newton, 15 newton, are acting along sides LMNO of a rectangle LMN. Okay, some sides are given. So first of all, I will draw a rectangle. So we are given that the forces acting are 25 newton along LM. So along LM, there is a 25 newton force. Then along MN, there is a 25 newton force. Along NO, there is 15 newton. And along OL, there is a 15 newton force. We need to find out the resultant force will be inclined at. Inclined at means we need to find out theta, for which we require 10 inverse of Fy by Fx. So first we need Fy and then we need Fx. So let us start with that. Summation of Fy is equal to, adding all the forces in x direction, I will get 25 minus 50 is equal to minus 25 newtons. Summation of Fx. Fx will be again 25 minus 50, which is equal to minus 25 newtons. So Fx and Fy both are equal. So theta will be, theta is equal to 10 inverse of 1, then theta is equal to 45 degrees. So option will be option number B. Next question. A vertical parallel force system has 4 forces. Okay, so I will make it. So first, there is a parallel force system which has 4 forces. They are placed one after another with a distance of separation 1 meter each between them. So if there are 3 forces, they are placed at a distance of 1 meter distance between them. The first force acts upward and has a magnitude of 100 newton. So first force will be somewhere here, and its magnitude is upward 100 newton after 1 meter because the distance should be 1. The second force has magnitude of 200 newton and acts upward. There is one force here that is acting upward of 200 newton. The third and the fourth force have equal magnitude of 400. Okay, the third force is acting downwards. The third force is acting downwards with a magnitude of 400 newton. Whereas the fourth one acts upward. The fourth one is acting upward. of 400 meters. The distance is 1 meter, 1 meter and 1 meter. This is what is experiment. Find the position of resultant. Position of resultant means we need to apply Verignon serum. And for Verignon serum, first we need the resultant. So we need resultant. R will write R is equal to 100 plus 200 minus 400 plus 400. So I will get R is equal to 300 meters. So once we got R, we can now find the position of resultant by applying Verignon serum. So we apply Verignon serum. Let us say summation of moments of all forces. Let us say we will take this point as A. About A should be equal to moment of resultant about same point A. Now let us take moment of the all forces. So if I go line by line, this will be 0 because it is passing through same point. This is making an anti-clockwise movement, so it will be 200 into distance is 2. Then if I go forward, this is making a clockwise movement, so it will be minus 400 into 2. Then this is making an anti-clockwise movement, so it will be plus 400 into 3 is equal to. This should be equal to movement of the resultant. The resultant is making anti-clockwise movement, so it will be 300 multiplied by, if I assume that this distance is x. So 600 is equal to 300x, so I will get x is equal to 2 meters. So I have taken it from A, so I will get 2 meters on the left of the first force. No, this is not the answer. Yeah, the answer is 2 meters on the right of first force. So on the right side of first force, it is at a distance of 2 meters. So option will be option C. Next question. Three forces are acting at point A. Okay, so I will make a point A. The forces are P equal to 150 Newton along east. So first of all, we will take the geographical map. So geographical map, this is west, this is east, south and north. North and south. So first is 150 Newton along east. So this will be one force of 150 Newton. Then Q is 200 Newton along north. So along north, there is Q, which is equal to 200 Newton. And S is equal to 150 along west. So along west, there is 150 Newton force. All are acting to point A. We are required to find out their resultant. So it's very simple. This 150 and this 150 will cancel out each other. So only remaining force is 200 Newton towards north. So answer will be B, 200 Newtons along the north. Option B. Next question. Under the application of which of the following force system, body undergoes pure rotational motion, purely a rotational motion? Coplanar concurrent force system. Coplanar concurrent force system. So here, coplanar concurrent. No, in this purely rotation, not possible. They can be rotational, there can be linear motion also. Coplanar parallel force system. Next is coplanar parallel force system. So if I make a parallel force system, so let us try to tell you, so yes, this is giving the pure rotation. It is a couple of anti-clockwise direction. So this is the condition which will give the pure rotational motion. Answer will be option B. Next question. Two forces, 30 Newton and 40 Newton, are acting at an angle of 50 degrees to each other. Okay, so there is one force of 30 Newton and there is another force of 40 Newton acting at an angle of 50 degrees with each other and are passing through one single point, the resultant of force. So we know that we can use parallelogram law of force if two forces are passing through the same point, and I can find out the resultant by the diagonal of parallelogram. So I will write R is equal to square root of 40 square plus 30 square plus 2 into 40 into 30 into cos of 50. So if I solve this, I will get the answer R is equal to 63.58 Newton, which is option number A. Next question. The figure shown below portrayed. So this is the figure which is shown. So you can see that there is three reactions shown, horizontal, vertical and a movement. And we know that three reactions are shown in a fixed support. So answer will be D, option D, fixed. we know that for a roller support there is only one reaction, for hinge there is two reactions, and for a fixed support there are three, and here the three reactions are shown, hence it will be a fixed support. Next question. Find reaction at point A for the figure. So we need to find out what is BA for this figure. So first thing is you can go by usual method. So let me go by usual method first, then I will give you shortcut. So first is I will apply summation of Fy is equal to 0. So if I apply Fy is equal to 0, I will get BA plus BB minus 10 is equal to 0, and I will get BA plus BB is equal to 10. Let this be equation number 1. Then I will take moment about point A. So I will get summation of moment about A should be 0. So I will get minus 10 into 1 plus BB into 4 equal to 0. So I will get BB is equal to 10 upon 4, which is equal to 2.5 kilometers. Now what students do in hurry? They mark 2.5 as the answer. But question was find reaction at point A, not B. So put this value here. I will get VA is equal to 7.5 kilometers, which is option number A. So this entire thing was the usual method. If I want to show you the shortcut, so it will be, if I want VA, we write VA is equal to the distance after the force. So the distance after the force is 3 divided by total distance. So it will be 4 multiplied by 10, the force value. So it will be 30 by 4. Is equal to 7.5. So directly you can get the answer. Similarly, if you want to find out VB, so I want to find VB, the distance opposite to the force, that is 1. So it will be 1 divided by total distance is 4, multiplied by force value is 10. So it will be 2.5. So this is the short. Next question. Which of the following statement is false? Magnitude of a moment of a force is obtained by a multiplying the magnitude of the force by its shortest distance. Okay, it's correct. Perpendicular distance means shortest distance. The moment of a force in the vector quantity S is as direction, clockwise, anticlockwise. Moment of a force is always the same respective of the location. No, this is wrong statement. This is the false. Moment changes as the distance or the point changes. We have seen this. If you take, let us say, there is a force here of 20 Newton, and this is point A, this is point B. If I take moment about A, the force will be, moment will be 20 into 1. If I take moment about point B, it will be 0. So it is changing from moment point to point. So this is the false option. So answer will be C, it is false. Next question. The forces which do meet at a point but lie in the single plane are known as. They meet at a single point and lie in the single plane. So it's really simple. It's a concurrent coplanar force system. It's a coplanar concurrent force. Yes, option will be A. Next question. If three non-parallel forces are in equilibrium, then it should be. If I tell you that three forces are in equilibrium, then it should be a concurrent force system. We have seen this in the Lami's theorem. If three concurrent forces are passing through one point and are in equilibrium. So for three non-parallel forces, there should be only one condition which gives the equilibrium part, which is a concurrent force system. So this will be a concurrent force. Next. Resultant of coplanar concurrent force system is given by, this is a very simple question, R is given by root of fx square plus fy square. Fx means horizontal forces, so I will get summation of x square plus summation of vertical forces in b square. So the answer will be option number D. No, option number C. Square root of b square plus x square. The correct option. Next. Condition of equilibrium for concurrent non-coplanar force. Non-coplanar force means forces in space. So for concurrent coplanar forces, concurrent non-coplanar forces, so it will be like this. Just passing through one single point, but it is non-coplanar. And if I want the condition of equilibrium, so we have seen this, the condition of equilibrium will be all the forces in x direction, y direction, z direction. So I will write fx0, fy0, fz0. So this is the correct option. Option B. Next question. The resultant of two forces P and Q acting at an angle theta. So this is P and this is Q. So this is P, this is Q, and this is the angle theta. So we know that it can be found by parallelogram law of force, and R value, we know that R is equal to square root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So the option will be this square. Root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Option B. Next question. The resultant of two forces P and Q is R. Okay. So if Q is doubled, then the new resultant is perpendicular to P. Then, so let me first make the forces. So let us say this is P, and let us say this force is 2P. Now it is said that the resultant is perpendicular to P. So let's make a resultant here. The resultant is perpendicular to P. Okay, so now as there are two forces passing through one single point, I can apply parallelogram law of force, in which I have the formula tan theta. Tan theta is Q sine alpha divided by P plus Q cos alpha. Okay. Now in this, we are given that this theta is 90 degree. We are directly given the resultant is taking 90 degree. So if tan of 90 I will take, that means it is infinity. So for this to be infinity, what should be zero? This should be zero. That means I will get therefore P plus Q cos alpha should be zero. Why zero? Because I need infinity here. So if P plus Q cos alpha is equal to zero, I will get P is equal to minus Q cos alpha. Or I can write P is equal to, or I can write cos alpha is equal to minus P by Q. But we are given that this is 2Q. Q is nothing but 2Q. If it is 90 degrees, so I will replace Q by 2Q. So we got cos alpha is equal to minus P by 2Q. Now we also know that the R is, the new resultant R is equal to square root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha. So I will write therefore R is equal to root of P square will be same Q square plus 2PQ. In place of cos alpha, I will write minus P by 2P. So I will write therefore R is equal to square root of P square plus Q square. This Q and Q cancelled. I will write just minus 2P square. Minus 2P square. So R is equal to, this 2P will get cancelled also. So I will get therefore R is equal to square root of P square minus P square will get cancelled, Q square. Therefore I will write R is equal to, the answer is Q is equal to R. So this solution will be satisfied. Next question. Effect of a force on a body depends on. So we see, we have seen the characteristics of forces. It has magnitude, direction, point of application, and the line of action. So the C is covered in option B, concept of action. Next question. For a coplanar concurrent force system, the conditions of equilibrium are. So we have sum of force in x direction 0, correct. Sum of force in y direction is 0, correct. Sum of moment about any force is 0. This is not required for concurrent force. So for concurrent, it is only x direction 0. Y direction. This is the correct answer, option A.